W tym roku sezon seminaryjny rozpoczynamy w taki specjalny sposób, bo rozpoczynamy sympozjum, które jest poświęcone dorobkowi naukowemu pani profesor Rity Szymczak. To serdecznie Państwa witam, szczególnie tych naszych gości, którzy przyjechali spoza Warszawy. Bardzo nam miło, że Państwo przyjechali do Instytutu i też będą się zabierali głos. I chcę zrobić krótki komentarz, dlaczego od pewnego momentu zaczniemy mówić po angielsku. Pani profesor Szymczak miała bardzo wielu współpracowników i to sympozjum chcemy utrwalić, nagrać wykłady i później również udostępnić je, mieć jakąś trwałą pamiątkę. No, a dla szeregu współpracowników spoza Polski, no, jedyną możliwością jest, jeżeli to będą prezentacje w języku angielskim, więc stąd, mimo że większość z nas oczywiście jest z Polski, poza profesorem Trojańczukiem, który będzie miał wykład po przerwie, dlatego te wykłady będą wygłaszane po angielsku. Tu jest wyświetlony program seminarium. Ja zrobię krótki wstęp, później dwa wykłady, no można powiedzieć wspólnym mianownikiem jest struktura domenowa. Po przerwie profesor Trojańczuk będzie mówił o perowskitach i profesor Pawlik, ten długi tytuł na końcu. Nawet jeżeli nie będziecie Państwo mogli z różnych powodów być na całym sympozjum, a chcielibyście wziąć udział w dyskusji, zapraszam około 12:45, gdzie na pewno te wykłady nie poruszą wszystkich aspektów działalności pani profesor. Gdyby ktoś z Państwa chciał coś dodać, to bardzo proszę przyjść też w czasie dyskusji. So, my short talk will give some brief review of various papers, which will be not discussed in details by the next lecturers. So, I will give you some important dates and statistics from curriculum vitae of Professor Szymczak. Next, I will mention her studies of phase transition in oxide magnetic materials. Part of her activity were devoted to basic properties of bulk superconductors, also magnetic properties of thin films, two or three very interesting papers of impact of light of magnetic properties. I will mention this. Next, magnetic properties of cobaltites and more recent papers devoted to frustrated magnetic systems. Professor Rita Szymczak studied at the Moscow State University, Lomonosov University. And at that time, it was really a lot of great lecturers, including Professor Landau. She mentioned me sometimes that she listened to his lectures, also passed the exam. So I think it was really a great opportunity to learn physics from such a great physicist. She arrived to Poland in 1961, and at first she was employed at the Institute of Fundamental Technological Research, next at the Institute of Electron Technology. She was employed in our institute since 1969. She obtained a PhD in 1967. Her PhD thesis was devoted to magnetic structure of the ferromagnets with uniaxial symmetry. The supervisor of the thesis was Professor Romuald Wadas. Also, I remember when I talked with her, she mentioned that during her exam for PhD studies, one of the member of the committee was Professor Stefan Szczeniowski. This is also a great person in Polish physics. So during this time, she really had opportunity to pass the exam. I think it was quite a good experience to pass exams when examinators are so brilliant physicists. She prepared her habilitation in early 80s, and in 1983 she obtained habilitation for studies of impact of temperature on domain structure of uniaxial magnetism. In 1992 she obtained title of a professor. Well, generally speaking, she was very active. 370 papers cited more than 2,065 times. I would say, personally for me, this period is very impressive because last years of her activity, it was also serious illness. So the fact that so many papers, she participated in studies in preparation of papers, was really something what says us about her very strong personality. Of course, her works were recognized since 1971. She obtained six times award of the scientific secretary of the Polish Academy of Science. In 1981, scientific award of Division 3. In 1987, joint award of the Presidium of Polish Academy of Science and Academy of Science of Soviet Union. In this case, it was collaboration with colleagues from Kharkov. And it was for a series of papers devoted to magnetic studies of inhomogeneous state in magnetic materials. Relatively recently, she was also awarded by joint award of the Polish Academy of Science and the Russian Academy of Science for a series of publications devoted to the development of physical-chemical basis of technology of new spintronic materials. From our institute, it was also Professor Dobrowolski and Dr. Kiliański, and Professor Rita Szymczak. It was a team of these three persons. She was supervisor of thesis of Professor Andrzej Szewczyk, of Professor of University of Białystok, Ryszard Geniusz, of Professor Jarek Zawadzki, and of Pablo Eleszkiewicz. Of course, she's got a lot of collaboration. Here is a list. I didn't mention everyone or mention only the names of the team leaders, co-author of 370 papers, of course, but a lot of collaborators. So, just to give a brief flash on several papers, I think a very important paper, it was this paper which was prepared in collaboration with colleagues from Kharkov. As you will see later, this collaboration with this group, especially with Professor Gnatchenko, was very fruitful also in next years. And in the case of this paper, it was really something interesting. They studied ferrimagnet, dysprosium orthoferrite, and they discover a new first order phase transition induced by magnetic field parallel to the AXIS. It was studies of single crystal. And also in this paper, a phenomenological description of the spin orientation was proposed. Also, this paper shows something what we'll talk about, Professor Maziejewski, the strength and beauty of studies of magnetic domains, because we in particular studied magnetic domains near phase transition and got a lot of very interesting results, also indicating phase first order type of a transition. Two papers which I choose concerning superconductors. In relatively early, it was recognized that there is a great impact of radiation defects on the properties of superconductors. Mainly it was studies of extrinsic parameters like critical current or irreversibility line, but still it was very interesting how neutron defects affects the intrinsic parameters. And this paper, which I show here, was devoted to the studies of neutron irradiation-induced defects in IPCO single crystals, and in particular anisotropy of the first critical field, and magnetic field penetration depth was studied. In my opinion, very, very interesting paper. Also, I would like to mention a second paper concerning superconductivity. That's a specific superconductor, which at this time was very, that's, I think still is very interesting one, because it was, of course, that time it was one, you can say, era of Hoop rates, and it was superconductor without copper, with bismuth, with relatively high critical temperature of about 30 Kelvin. So it was interesting to understand the mechanism of the superconductivity. And what I want to say concerning this paper, and when I read it, I was really impressive how tutorial is this paper. Namely, it is shown how from the studies of magnetization, how many parameters we can derive from this studies of magnetization. In particular, even electron phonon coupling was derived, and of course it says something about mechanism of pairing. Also, if someone wants to learn how to study pinning force, it is also a very good paper, because one of the co-authors from United Kingdom, some years ago, he introduced some method of scaling of the pinning force, which allows, when one finds the parameter of this scaling, to say something about type of defect. So really, I encourage, if someone wants to learn how to study superconductors, just read this paper. Two interesting papers concerning thin films of perovskites. That's IPCO, that's IPCO thin film, but with low oxygen stoichiometry, so this film is not superconducting. This film is antiferromagnet. And in this paper, it was very convincing evidence for formation of ferromagnetic clusters, which are promoted by the oxygen holes. These clusters are formed in copper oxygen planes, which contain some potential wells of size of 100 of latest sites. And what was, in my opinion, very interesting result shown here, that illumination by laser light leads to increase in the number of holes. So, because of creation of cluster magnetization increase. The second paper, by the way, here also, Professor Natchenko, and here, Professor Natchenko are co-authors. In this case, it was studies of praseodymium thin film, and also interesting results and interesting physics brings laser irradiation. They found that after about 1-2 hours, there is saturation of magnetization change. And generally speaking, light affects phase separation. All these perovskites exhibit very strong phase separation. And like turn out to be very fruitful tool to let's say, light have impact of this phase separation. And in the case of this film, it was a low temperature below 50 K. It was increase of magnetization, and again ferromagnetic clusters were created in antiferromagnetic matrix. What is interesting, this effect was quite stable, because at low temperature, after 20 hours of after illumination, this increase of magnetization still holds. One of the studies of Professor Rita Szymczak was also devoted to effect of pressure on cobaltites. As you know, cobaltites exhibits very interesting properties due to possible different spin states of cobalt depending on temperature, and also in this case it was also shown that other factors like pressure has impact on cobalt spin state. And in this case Professor Rita Szymczenko and co-workers studied cobaltite with two different ions, namely strontium and calcium, but ions with different ionic radius would turn out to be important in this case. So in cobaltite with calcium, they found that there is, under pressure, there is transition from intermediate spin state to low spin state, and ferromagnetic interactions weakens. For the cobaltite with larger ionic radius, I mean strontium, it was opposite, pressure enhances the ferromagnetic interaction, and also they observed pressure-induced phase transition. And also, there is quite good and deep physics in this paper, which gives us explanation in terms of competition between EG electron bandwidth and crystal field splitting, why these effects are different. The last paper which I want to mention was also very interesting. It was studies of frustrated system of cobalt vanadate and oxygen. This is so-called Kagome staircase structures. These crystals were grown in our institute, and because it was combined magnetization and specific heat studies, this paper is very conclusive. I mean, there is a variety of phase transition at low temperature, and together with magnetization studies were, for example, for fields applied parallel to the C-axis, several jumps in magnetization were observed. Combining together these results, also this paper contains very firm conclusions. So I will end with some temporary conclusions that, in my opinion, Professor Rita Szymczak's investigation really give us very interesting review of research on the most hot topics in magnetism. And really, we can learn a lot from her papers. And I believe that following lectures will also support this conclusion. So thank you.
Good morning. It is great honor and pleasure for me to be here and to give this presentation. I would like to focus on the importance, rarity and beauty of magnetic domain studies given by Professor Krzymczak. This study, it was done in the first part of her activity, because she made, as was mentioned before, her PhD thesis and habilitation in on domains. She made also popularization of domains structure in two monographies and encyclopedia. I was involved in activity on domains study since 1972, when I started my research after her guidance. So I would like to say that I am a follower of Professor Krzymczak. And in Białystok we continued study of magnetic domains, and one can say that even we have now three generation of followers, because of this generation of PhD and second generation of PhD. I will discuss about some results connected with also with our following study, which was broken by Professor Krzymczak. And here there are, I would like also mention two, three followers in Professor Krzymczak's team. Of we, Professor Krzymczak was promoter, supervisor of some person from our team. She was also a referee. And here it is a photo from the defense of Professor Tekielak, one can find Professor Krzymczak, and it's the same hall, but we can find changes looking for numbers of photos on the wall. Okay, and of course, magnetic domain structure studies was done by Professor Krzymczak in wide collaboration with people from Institute of Physics, also from some Polish institution, and from different institutions from abroad. Especially important was this collaboration with people from Kharkov. I would like to focus my presentation on following topics. Bulk domains, I will give short introduction, bulk magnetic domains. The studies domains in autofight will be main part of this presentation, domains in high anisotropy ferromagnets, one slide connected with domain application, and then conclusions. Introduction. Modern magnetism could be started at beginning of last century by Weiss theory. One can distinguish two branches of this study. One is connected with the physics of ordering in the domain, and it is connected with exchange interaction, magnetic anisotropy, relation between anisotropy and magnetization. And there is very important also Jaworzynski-Moria interaction. I will try to discuss this also in this presentation. And second branch of the study is connected with study of domains. So the relation between domain sizes, orientation, polarization, this, and size of the sample, and also as a function of external magnetic field and temperature. Bulk magnetic domains. It is well known that depending on relation between demagnetization and anisotropy, we have magnetic plate index and magnetic plate, Kittel model structure, so-called open structure, or Landau-Lipschitz structure with closure domains. This Landau-Lipschitz model is when Q is smaller than half. Professor Krzymczak proposed a new model, a so-called Rita-Krzymczak model, with partially closed structure. And this model is valid when U is smaller than 1.1. She found also the dependence of size driven size of the thickness. It is the question, what is Maxician distribution uniaxial magnet with low EQ? Answer of this question could be done using micromagnetic calculations. And here it is magnetization distribution cobalt 100 nanometer thick plate. And XY, XZ vector, magnetization vector is visible here. And Y, the component of magnetization is coded by the color. And one can find here that this distribution is just the distribution proposed by the Professor Itashevich. It was really very great intuition to propose such kind of model, which is approved by micromagnetic simulations. For cobalt, it was studied domain structure as a function of thickness. You can see huge change of thickness of plate from 10,000 nanometers to 4.1 nanometer, and decrease in thickness. There is disappearance of domains for thickness of about 50 nanometers. Transition from such kind of domain structure to in plane state. There is a question, what is below for lower surfaces? No domains? Of course not. It is a region where there is a huge influence of thickness because of surface is affected on magnetic anisotropy. And here one can find also dependence of domains as a function of thickness. One can find two phase transitions from perpendicular to plane for this thicknesses of cobalt. In the case of nanostructure, it is possible even to have more complicated situation because using laser annealing for the state of cobalt with 3 nanometer thickness, it is possible to obtain irreversible transition from in plane to perpendicular state in the microscopy, and it is NFM picture. So even four phase transition can be obtained for this nanostructure. The samples were obtained in this institute by Professor Vavro. Let's go to domain structure theory. It was developed by Professor Szymczak, so one can find the simple model, and after this, domain structure is more complicated. It is possible to obtain spikes, complicated domain structure close to the surface. It is open question how to study this problem. It is possible to use the classical method Bitter technique using stray field and location of magnetic particles around domain one. It is known from its surface. But Professor Szymczak developed new, and co-workers developed new technique connected with solid oxygen. It was really interesting and important proposition because if I know it is cryostat was broken and something happens with domains with a pattern, with pattern with not known pattern, and after this physical analysis of this properties gave opportunity to find to explain this effect by location of this solid oxygen, and afterwards to apply this idea to new method of domain imaging. Here it is a result of the visualization of domain wall in the orthophagy. Low temperature, 6 seconds. The perforation track uses also magneto-optical effects, and it is possible to have reflected light and transmitted light and different types of Kerr effects and Faraday effects. And using special optics, it is possible to obtain or geometrical image of domains, or it is possible to have diffraction image. She uses both techniques. And here there are results connected beautiful picture of domains structure obtained using two techniques, infrared Faraday effect, and one can see inside domains, and here surface domain by Bitter pattern. These results published in Acta Physica Polonica, but these results were well recognized by scientific publicity, especially in this article on domains, Professor Hubert's book on magnetic domains, and in this book, this picture was used, and it was mentioned that a particularly beautiful demonstration of branching is due to Rita Szymczak's work. It is unique that he used name in this book. It is very this structure is connected with complicated domain structure close to the surface of the plate. I would like now to show a little about application of magneto-optical techniques which we made as followers in Youngstock. It is possible to have light in Faraday configuration in transmission and light in reflection. And in reflection, depending on the direction of magnetization, it is possible to have different configuration of Kerr effect. After this, it is possible here for Perniberg configuration, it is possible to have so-called polar magnetoptic Kerr effect, and this configuration is sensitive for Z component of magnetization. And playing with different illumination and using image processing, it is possible to obtain full information about magnetization orientation, MX, MY, and MZ components. And this technique we use it for this garnet obtained from Japan. And one can find here it is in transmission using Faraday effect domain structure, and here it is in reflection, the PMOG. It is very similar as the picture obtained by Professor Rita Szymczak we use it also imaging on side wall, and it is possible to define direction of magnetization in this system. And here one can see that even we have it is possible to distinguish different third generation of spikes, because we have white, and black again. So it is complicated structure. It is possible also to study as a function of magnetic field, for example, the nuclear, and one can find evolution of surface domains and volume domains using magneto-optical Kerr effect. It is possible also to model using electromagnetic simulations such kind of distribution. For this garnet, for this thicknesses, it is a problem much more complicated, because it is necessary to have 10 to 7 cells. For this configuration, it is necessary to have 10 to 12. It's not possible in the present time. And after this, it is possible also to open this dummies. Start. However, for such kind of micrometric garnets, micromagnetic simulation up to now are not good enough. Modeling similar as also gravitation mathematical description is much more. Okay, and I would like also to say about new effects. It is well known that magneto-optical paradigm effect is connected to different velocity of right and left circularly polarized light. And it is possible to expect another effect that after illumination by right or left polarized light, one can obtain effects similar as magnetic field. And using such kind of magnetic, such kind of light pulses, that one can expect that it is possible to excite magnetization. Really, it was the case in the system, and here it is a result obtained by third generation of Rita-Shenchak follower, it is possible to obtain different oscillations from gigahertz to terahertz range using special pump and probe technique with a femtosecond laser. Okay, and now domains in the octofarad. Professor Wiśniewski mentioned about this topic in this presentation. I would like to discuss it more. In this system, it is very important to consider Dzierżyński-Moria interaction. And in this case, Dzierżyński vector is along y on all the axes. In such situation, it is possible to obtain three different configurations of spins in antiferromagnetic state along y axis and two weak ferromagnetic states along x axis and along z axis. In the 60s and 70s, this system was intensively studied and for different composition, different effects, and one can find that approximately the same Curie temperature, about 600 degrees, that is with final gamma 4 phase. And transition to gamma 2 phase of this blue. And very interesting transition to gamma 1 to antiferromagnetic state is gold region as a function of temperature. First, I would like to show some results connected with study around Curie temperature, or more precisely, Knell temperature. Here it is a result obtained on octoferrite, and it is dependence of, as a function of temperature, normalizing magnetization, and one can find here this temperature, and here it is dependence of domain period as a function of temperature. One can find drastic decrease of size, of domain size, with some critical size. And after calculation of domain wall, one can find huge increase of domain wall width. This phenomena was described by introduction of so-called linear domain wall, which is has an influence on dependence of period as a function of temperature and critical period here. This distribution is here written. And one can find that in the middle of the wall, there is vanishing of magnetization amplitude. Similar behavior were observed also in another systems in Garnet and also in this system. Next system, it is a system connected with dysprosium, and here we have for larger, for temperature above 40 degrees, we have a weak ferromagnetic state up and down, and we have antiferromagnetic state below 40 degrees. And in the 60s, it was not clear what is the transition. And it was explained by observation made by Professor Itashinchak that decreasing temperature, there is creation of antiferromagnetic state, and the volume of the state increases decreasing temperature. So this first order phase transition, this transition could be driven also by magnetic field. Here magnetic field is applied along the axis in this direction, and in this case one can see very nice increase of domains, black domains with magnetization along minus z axis. This dispersion of the freight were intensely studied in collaboration with Professor Jeremienko, Dachenko, Harchenko, the team in Kharkov. And it was studied not only as a function of temperature, but as a function of high magnetic field. Oriented with different orientation. Let us discuss the situation with antiferromagnetic state and magnetic field applied along B axis, this antiferromagnetic vector direction. Here one can find a beautiful picture, the connective creation gamma for phase. It is by spin flow to weak ferromagnetic state, from antiferromagnetic to weak ferromagnetic. Using field applied along B and C direction, this say constructed phase diagram of gamma 1 combined for phases. It was also studied as for magnetic field applied along A axis. Typically, one can expect that this transition should be by rotation of magnetization from this axis to this axis applying this field. However, it was found that this transition is more complicated with additional phase, so-called gamma 1, 2 phase, is this phase, and also phase diagram were constant. And now I would like to mention that this process octoferrite was intensively investigated in recent years by Professor Theorizing team in Nijmegen, and here this paper where inverse Faraday effect was observed at 100 Kelvin. I would like to mention that this 200 femtosecond pulse is with fluence 500 millijoule by square centimeters corresponds to effective field of 5 Tesla. So this really huge, very fast effective field impulse. It was studied as a function of different orientation of light pulses, different excitation were observed. And very recent work done in Professor Rising team with reference to the Professor Rita Szymczak paper is connected with creation of electromagnetic state from anti-ferromagnetic state, depending on anti-ferromagnetic domains in different configurations. Nice, very nice. Continuation of Rita Szymczak paper. And now three additional exams for ortho-ferrite, Erdim ortho-ferrite and Thulium ortho-ferrite. This various phase transition from gamma to gamma 4 to gamma 2, the heating temperature, and also there is compensation of magnetization. Here for Erdim ortho-ferrite as a function of temperature, it is dependence of domain wall width, and one can find a huge increase of domain size approaching this compensation the point. And for thulium ortho-ferrite, it is transition from gamma 2 to gamma 4, and there is huge decrease of domain size. It was described by Tori, but I have no time to discuss more details. It is possible also to have a combination of composition of arrived Earths, and for example, in this composition, it is possible to have two Morin transitions from with antiferromagnetic state and transition to gamma 4 and gamma 2 transition. And is this work? Domain wall energy was investigated as a function of the temperature, and for high temperature, the very classical domain wall with rotation of magnetization. For lower temperature, there is dependence with change of magnetization lines. Experimental data are well described by the theoretical description. Domains in highly anisotropic ferromagnets. I will give two examples. First, it is connected with uranium phosphate. It is from research. This is where Rita Szymczak was promoter. It is system with huge magnetic anisotropy, cubical magnetic anisotropy. So one can expect four easy axes. And the magnetic domain structure in this system strongly depends on magnetic history. It was studied by Polak. In fact, here it is demagnetized sample by cooling from the temperature above cubic temperature. And the domain structure is connected with incline free direction. And when it was supported by systematic study of magnetization distribution, domain structure on different walls. And when the magnetic field was applied perpendicular to the sample, it was possible to obtain another configuration, typical and similar as for uniaxial magnet. Also some with complicated domain structure approaches of cycles. And second example, it is connected with also huge anisotropic samarium system. And here imaging by oxygen condensation was used, and from analysis of domain wall energy as a function of wall width, it was possible to found that the domain wall is monatomic, so-called ferroelectric-like domains, with domains up or down without transition. It is for low temperature, for temperature I find, but for higher temperature, size of domain structure was studied, and wall energy was defined. And here, from the theoretical description, so-called linear form with vanishing of magnetization was deduced. This theoretical description will describe experimental data. And last result, it is connected with application of domains. Domains are beautiful, but also one can lose it. And here, this application of domain structure analysis. In this garnet, this garnet with huge contrast magnetic domain to study superconducting crystal, and it was studied as a function of magnetic. It was possible to find distribution flux in the superconducting material depending on magnet on history as a function of the result is possible as a function of time. Okay, and conclusions. Analytical modeling and combining experimental technique studies of bulk domains, domain beauty. Continuation. Additionally to analytical modeling, it is useful to make micromagnetic simulations. We have now very good computer support software for this. And here I would like to underline this intuition, intuition proposing this model analysis. And additionally to BITEC technique, I think that now magnetoscopy technique are very useful. Second, domain is driven by temperature and magnetic field, this picture from this orthoferrite. And new magnetization dynamics driven by ultra-fast light pulses. Domains in various systems with strong Działoszyński-Moria interaction. Results from this study, I think that could be very important for understanding of Działoszyński-Moria interaction, which now is very intensively studied on the magnetic conference in nanostructures. And it is important, for example, for experiments. Domains approaching Curie temperature. Here it is open question, what happens in this region? What is the properties of the magnets? Now there are techniques connected with Bill and light scattering, which could be used for this experiment. But we wait more than 20 years or 30 years to make such kind of studies. And of course, it is possible now to drive this phase transition, not only by temperature, but also by electric field. Here there are very nice recent results obtained by Japanese co-workers, where this transition is driven by electric field. And the domains could be used for investigations on superconducting materials. I would like to mention that Professor Rita Szymczak works were recognized. Her results were used in books, very recent books. Also books prepared by Professor Wysłocki team. I have not mentioned last book which you have presented. So of course, I would like to specially mention this book, Hubert book. Okay, so this summary of this. And I would like that to mention that Professor Rita Szymczak gave important contribution to theoretical and experimental studies of magnetic domains and wider to magnetism. I think that she combined this idea, mentioned before, the idea of Weiss. She combined domains and physics of inside of organization. She gave excellent, she was an excellent physicist, teacher, friend, very good person. And to, I would like now to summarize this after the defense of Professor Tegielak, you can see.